Come sing a song of joy, for peace shall come, my brother. Sing, sing a song of joy, for men shall love each other. Will done just as sure as hearts that are pure, our hearts set free. No man must stand alone without stretched hands before him. Reach out and take them in yours with love that endures forevermore. Then sing a song of joy for love and understanding.
September, the European Day of Languages. The European Day of Languages is 26 September, as proclaimed by the Council of Europe on 6 December 2001, at the end of the European Year of Languages 2001, which had been jointly organized by the Council of Europe and the European Union. Its aim is to encourage language and learning across Europe. The general objectives of the European Day of Languages are to alert the public to the importance of language learning and diversify the range of languages learned in order to increase plurilingualism and intercultural understanding, promote the rich linguistic and cultural diversity of Europe, encourage lifelong language learning in and out of school. In keeping with these rules, people, young and old, are encouraged to take up a language or take special pride in their existing language skills. Also, those responsible for providing access to language learning are encouraged to make it easier for people to learn a range of languages and to support policy initiatives to promote languages. There is also emphasis on learning a language other than English. On the occasion of the day, a range of events are organized across Europe, including those for children, television and radio programs, language classes and conferences. The events are not organized by the Council of Europe or the European Union, nor do they all allocate special funding. Apart from their existing language programs for the day, member states and potential partners are given a free hand to organize activities. To coordinate the activities organized at the national level, the Council of Europe asked participating countries to nominate national relay persons for the day. The national relay in the UK is CALT, the National Centre for Languages. There are about 225 indigenous languages in Europe, roughly 3% of the world's total. Most of the European languages are of Indo-European origin. Since the end of the 18th century, the most widespread language of Europe, both in terms of geography and the number of native speakers, has been Russian, which replaced French. Counting only native speakers, approximately 150 million Europeans speak Russian on a daily basis, followed by German, 95 million, Turkish, 80 million, English and French each by 65 million, Italian 60 million, Spanish and Polish 40 million each, Ukrainian 30 million, and Romanian 26 million. As far as foreign language studies are concerned, English is currently the most popular foreign language in Europe, followed by German, French, Italian, Russian, Spanish. One of the smallest languages in Europe is Maltese, the national language of Malta. The European Union adheres to a policy of multilingualism both in its institutional workings and as an aim for its citizens. At the 2002 AEM Summit in Barcelona, it set a target for children to learn at least two foreign languages from an early age. Multilingualism for the EU is linked to work mobility and the European economy. The European Union spends more than 30 million a year promoting language learning and linguistic diversity through the Socrates and Leonardo da Vinci programs, policy that is the pioneering program.